Meet Alex. Alex is a 15-year-old with autism. A self-driving car takes Alex to school every day. On the way, a virtual assistant that simulates the voice of her mother interacts with her, guiding her through her daily routine. At school, Alex's class is aided by AI-powered diagnostic tools. Today, these tools told Alex's teachers that she struggled with yesterday's unit circle lesson and provided a helpful diagram as well as some practice problems to help her. As you probably guessed, Alex's world doesn't exist today, but it will soon. As we walk through her daily life, we saw many groundbreaking technologies, but one area is just so much further from becoming a reality than the others. And that is the integration of artificial intelligence into our education system. In Alex's world, education is fully accessible to every individual, regardless of their physical, cognitive, or sensory abilities. Now to us, this may seem like a far-fetched idea, but it's entirely feasible to make Alex's world our future using AI. To do this though, it's crucial to anticipate potential problems and plan for the future so that we can build a truly inclusive education system. Speaking of the education system, special education is a form of education that provides neurodiverse individuals and those with physical disabilities access to the tools and resources they need to achieve their full potential. Within the job of a special educator, it's inherent that you're going to have a large impact on your students' lives. Yet being a special educator is so hard and will only get harder in the future. There are over 7.2 million students currently enrolled in special education programs all across the United States. Yet there are only 470,000 teachers to serve them. This shortage of educators, as you can see in the chart above, is exacerbated by a disproportionate increase in the quantity of students as time progresses relative to that of teachers. That's where AI can come in. We can use AI-powered models, like the ones that were in Alex's classroom, to develop personalized learning experiences tailored to each individual's unique needs and abilities. These models can drive the cost of learning down for students because technological development, especially software, is easily scalable and cost-effective. These tools can also allow for an increase in class capacity without decreasing the quality of instruction for students. Lower costs mean that we can make education more accessible to families who don't traditionally have access to resources like therapists and psychologists. And even with the reduced cost, we can bring about a personalized education system that increases student engagement and retention rates. By analyzing the data collected on a student, AI models can identify patterns and adjust teaching methods and instruction within a classroom accordingly. This means that students can receive the support they need to learn at their own pace and in their own way. By bringing about a personalized learning experience for our students, we can bring higher quality education to more people than ever before. We can provide direct and targeted advice that helps students get the learning experience that they need and deserve. For example, we can use AI-powered gesture trackers, like the one in the video above, to determine whether an individual is learning how to use scissors properly. Helping teachers provide higher quality education to their students can also help foster a greater sense of independence for those students too. We can teach life skills such as how to fold laundry, do the dishes, or make lunch to those with disabilities to help them reach true independence and integrate better into society. We can also use AI to connect those around us and help those with their disabilities overcome their limitations in and out of the classroom. For example, we can use AI-powered speech recognition software to help those with speech impairments be able to better communicate with their teachers and peers. We can use AI-powered sentiment analysis algorithms to help those who have trouble understanding emotions be able to better read the room that they're in. We can also use AI to develop advanced prostheses that help those with physical disabilities overcome their limitations. Now, although we can see the potential of this technology, what does the future actually look like? I envision that the advancement and integration of this technology will occur in five distinct stages. Today, we're at a level zero. AI hasn't been implemented into our education system, And students learn the way that they always have, through teachers. As this technology advances, we see AI being used to provide simple data analytics to students and teachers, and using their classwork and grades. But with time, we can see AI being used to provide supplemental instruction. And what that means is that students will be given real-time analysis of their classroom performance during classroom time, and also these students and teachers will be able to adjust their instruction during class. At some point, we hit level three. At level three, we see AIs and human teachers working together to deliver instruction. This means that an AI may give instruction independently with assistance from a teacher, or they'll work together to provide instruction for their students. In contrast, at level four, we see AIs providing complete instructional experience for our society's future, and students learn through an AI, with educators only there for safety purposes. Now, although we can foresee a symbiosis between AIs and humans in the future, it's virtually non-existent today. And the sluggish integration of this technology is due to three major things: a lack of funding, a general resistance to change, and ethical concerns behind the development of these models. A main concern behind the development of any AI is responsibility and accountability. Precautions have to be taken when teaching our society's future, and we have to ensure that we omit potential biases in our data sets and omit vital student information. Regulations also have to be put in place to ensure that those developing these models are held accountable for their actions, and we as a society should advance this technology in a way that's safe and ethical. And that's because education isn't just about memorizing and reciting facts, but about developing tangible skills that students can use in their daily lives and to better our society. AIs are fundamentally incapable of providing the same unique life advice that a human can, because they don't experience the real world. They're just built out of data sets and made with no partiality. Now, before I close, let us remember that artificial intelligence is great at bringing adaptability to technology. But to reach its full potential, we have to invest in AI research and development, promote ethics and transparency, and ensure that these technologies are accessible and inclusive to all. And that's why AI should be used as a supplement to traditional education methods, not as a complete replacement to teachers. Let us keep in mind that AI isn't a magic wand that we can wave around to solve all the world's problems, but another tool that bridges the gap between humans and teachers to improve the way that we live. Let us make Alex's world a reality and build a future that connects us, not divides us. Thank you.